ओम श्री कृष्ण शरणं मम, श्री भागवत शरणं मम, श्री सद्गुरु शरणं मम, श्री सूता शरणं मम, श्री सुखदेव शरणं मम, श्री व्यासा शरणं मम, श्री नारद शरणं मम, श्री कुमार शरणं मम, श्री ब्रह्मा शरणं मम, श्री विष्णु शरणं मम, श्री परब्रह्म शरणं मम, श्री कृष्ण शरणं मम, श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारे, हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेव, श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारे, हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेव, श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारे, हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेव। ॐ मुखं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्प्रभातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम्। ॐ स्वर्गे सत्ये च कैलासे वैकुण्ठे नास्ति अमृतः, अतः पिबन्तु सद्भाग्याः, मा मुञ्चत कर्षित। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ श्रीकृष्णपरब्रह्मणे नमः। श्रीमद्भागवतमहापुराणम् एकादशस्कन्धः, मुक्तिरित्वान्यथारूपं स्वरूपेण व्यवस्थितिः। ॐ अथ एकादशोऽध्यायः। श्रीभगवानुवाच। Salutations to the Lord, to Vedavyasa Bhagavan, Shukadeva Bhagavan, Suta Bhagavan, and Sri Naraji and all Bhagavata Acharyas. What is the topic we are discussing in this 11th Skandha, 11th chapter is the Bhakta Lakshanas and the Bhakti practices. The Lakshanas of the Bhakta or Yogi or Jnani or Sadhu were told in the earlier Shlokas. Now, what makes it Bhakti? The list of huge list of sadhanas, around 20-30, Bhagavan said. All of them we have to perform, and while performing, we have to focus on perfection, and we have to offer all of them. And the result of all this is proximity to the Lord in terms of our remembrance, in terms of our devotion to Him. And surely from Lord's side also, all those conveniences that are required, all those blessings that are required, they keep start coming. And we don't do it in devotion or prema, prema for the sake of prema. So we will not bother about what Lord will have to give us. We will be assured by our mind that He will give what is to be given. Not focus on that, but proximity in the mind in terms of remembrance and offering. These two should happen in us, along with following all these sadhanas that are given. So first we have said, gunan doshan agnyaya agnyaya evam maya adhisthanapi svaka. All the guna doshas are taught by me only. In them, the gunas are taught so that we come out of the dosha yukta jivanam. In fact, I don't want you to be doing only the guna yukta jivanam and be away from me. More than living a life of all the guna, the better life is to be a bhakta of me. Therefore, after sufficiently performing the life of guna, in which the dharma is there, all the values that are said above are there, next step is, even you keep it aside and then come to me, either in devotion or in jnana. If that you can do, you are the greater of the devotees. Mam bhajeta saha sattamaha. What we have to catch here? Ultimately, reaching to Lord through bhakti or jnana alone can be the goal, is the goal, therefore should be taken as the goal, not anything else. To be able to become that way devoted, we are given all the above said gunas or sadhanas. We will do. But mam bhajeta sa sattamaha, that also dharman santyajya yaha sarvan. So sarva dharman parityajya. There in Gita called as parityajya. Same thing here said as santyajya. Sarva dharman, sarva dharman. There mam ekam sharanam vraja. Here mam bhajeta. There it is said mokshayishyami sarva papebhyah maashucha. Don't cry. You will be freed from all the problems, etc. Here he says Sahasattamaha is the best of the Bhakta. To a person who is so much worldly and reality of the world in his mind, these things won't click. He won't even believe the presence of Lord. Paramanastic. But slowly, ज्ञात्वा अज्ञात्वा च ये वै माम यावान यश्चास्मि यादृशः भजन्ति अनन्य भावेन ते मे भक्त तमामताः. इट्स वेरी सटल ट्रिक इज देयर हियर. हूएवर डज मई भजन अनन्य भाव दे आर अगेन द भक्त तमाः. हूएवर वेदर दे नो अबाउट मी इन एंटायरिटी इंटेलेक्चुअली by listening from the masters through the satsang, the shastras, or the one who doesn't. Both of them bhakta tamaha, knower and unknower. Why? Knower is great because he has known it, the greatness of God, and therefore he can truly worship the Lord because jnanam is there. The one who doesn't know, he doesn't know yet he is worshipping the Lord. In fact, he is also equally great. All his faith which was there in the world earlier, which was uncertain world, now with all that uncertainty he still is worshipping me. So it is so rare thing that a person has bhakti or shraddha in me without knowing about me. Yavan yadrushah yah cha asmi, how big I am, what I am, and what are my qualities or expressions, without knowing also you worship me. Therefore what is important is intellectual, theoretical knowledge about the Lord or ignorance of the Lord. No. What is important is, are we doing the bhajan of the Lord with faith or not? Bhajan of the Lord with faith when you don't know, with understanding when you know. So, Bhagavad Bhajana Ananya Bhave. That has got lot of things to explain in that, if you take the Vedantic explanation. So, Ananya Bhavena Bhajana means seeing only the Lord, nothing other than Him. What you want, anything, ask only the Lord. Then anything you have to do, do only what is said by the Lord through the Shastra and Guru. Then having done, offer everything again to the Lord only. Again, seek Lord only as your goal. This is what is the last shloka of chapter 9, chapter 11 of Gita. In the 9th chapter, Man Mana Bhava. Let your mind be always soaked in devotion to me. Mad Bhakta Bhava. Don't be a devotee of anybody else, mine only. Padyaji, whatever yagna yaga you do of me, offer it to me. Then Madhyaji, Mam Namaskuru, you do Namaskara only to me. This is called Ananya Bhava. Namaskara only to me means what? Anyone you are doing Namaskara to, you see the Lord and do Him. Do that Namaskara. Let the Jiva in Him receive your Namaskara, feel that you have done to Him, but you heart in heart do to the Lord in them. That's how Mam Namaskuru. Then Mama Eva Yeshas Yuktvaivam Atmana Mat Parayana. Keep me only as Mat Parayana. Mujahi Paramayan bhi manlo. Then you reach me. Same in 11th chapter, Mat Karma Krutu. Any karma you have to do or only should be related to me. Mat Bhaktaha. Be my devotee and Mat Paramaha. Keep me as Paramalaksha. Then what about the world? Only two. Nirvairaha Sarabhuteshu. Nirvairaha Sarabhuti. Then Matkarmakrut, Matparma, Vat, Sangavarjitaha, Nirvaira. No attachment and no enmity. Raga Dvesha Rahita with the world. And what is the meaning of Raga Dvesha Rahita with the world? Only with Dharma. In the world without Raga Dvesha and with Dharma you are living, with regard to the people and all other things you have to do. And toward the Lord, you do work only of mine. Keep me only as goal. And Matbhaktaha, may your all things are offered. The last chapter, last loka, 11th chapter. This is one of the most beautiful things. They are the conclusions of what was taught in that entire chapter. So here also, Ananya Bhavena Mam Bhajeta Saha Sattamaha, or yeah, he is online. Te me Bhakta Tamaha Vataha. In my opinion, they are the Bhakta Tamaha. Ajanya Vanema. So Ananya Bhavena, we explained. Ultimate Ananya Bhava is what? Ki, there is no world other than Bhagavan. Here the jnanam and bhakti come together. And there is nobody other than Bhagavan as me, the jiva also. What is the truth in him and what is the truth in me is same, one only. And what is the position of that I was so far remaining and establishing its separateness with the Lord and with the world? It was only pseudo. It's like a snake on the rope. It was there, but it appeared in the absence of the knowledge of the rope. So too, in the absence of the knowledge of the all permeability of the Lord, the individuality gathering for its existence whatever is required from the Paramatma only, as if maintained its separateness, as if it has its own entitification, but really it is not there. That is what is ultimate Ananya Bhakti, where we have discovered. Once, but as many times as required or possible, we keep on listening, contemplating, and slowly digesting till we become convinced that, oh, finally, this is what is the meaning of sadhana. This is what I have to do, and this is where I have to reach. In the world, we are there. With the body senses, we are perceiving, acting, responding. But heart in heart, this development of devotion and this development of knowledge. Devotion is everything is he is offering to him. Knowledge is he is me, me is he. Tvameva aham aham eva tvam. Aham brahma parandhama brahma aham paramam padam. Like that. Now comes the more gross practical sadhanas, which are called as bhakti sadhanas, are being told. The first two things are ultimate bhaktis. First practice gunas to transcend dosha, then even drop those gunas also, dharmas also, then only surrender to the Lord. It is one ultimate bhakti sadhana. Second level is know or don't know about him with ananya bhava. When you do bhakti, that is a bhakta tama. Now to reach to these first two levels, what are the things you have to generally do throughout the day? Keep all these as sadhanas, whatever maximum possible. And purpose of all of them is to develop bhakti towards the Lord, to have the jnanam about Lord that he alone is real. What is that? Mallinga madbhakta jana. First to remember these two. Mallinga means all the places where the Lord is symbolically kept. That can be our own house puja mandiram. That can be the puja mandirams in our own town or village, or any of the greatest of the temples that are there in the entire world. They are called Mallinga. That which indicates me. So all the murtis are kept in all the temples. Second is Madbhakta Jana. Madbhakta Jana, those are my devotees and great saints and sages, sadhus, gurus. Towards them, if these things are done, you are Bhakta. Towards Mallinga, the temple, Madbhakta Jana, the Mahatmas. Because the Mahatmas are moving temples of Lord. Because in them, the individuality is merged in the Lord. Lord experience is very much gained by him. Lord only expressing through him. The one is a mobile temple. There's no doubt about it. The individuality in him, which was seeking pleasures outside like you and me earlier, has totally transcended all vasanas, ignorances, extrovertedness. And that individuality dropped itself into the Paramatma. Therefore, he becomes mobile temple. Therefore, he also. So, Mallinga Madhakta Jana. Again, what to do towards both of them? One, darshana. Having the darshana. So, when you have the darshana, know that they are expression of God. Know that they are expression of God. And that God who is expressing through them. Through upasana, you will have his darshana as he is. Or through meditation, you discover them in your heart. To reach to that level, first of all, have the darshan of them. Chav se, prem se, regularly unka darshan karna. Physically go there, be in the presence of such mahatmas and be in those temples. In fact, make it a habit to visit to your nearby temples almost every day. I know some people, you know, apne ghar ke samne mandir hai, har din saalo saal jaate hain log. The blessings they invoke, the support they get from the Lord is enormous. And without their own knowing, the Lord is protecting them in so many ways. beautiful is that experience. And some people are more so devoted to Tirupati Balaji. There is a Mahatma, 17 or 18 or even more than that years, every day climbed and came down. Har din. सुबह 4 बजे उठना, 7 बजे जाना, 9 बजे दर्शन करना, फिर आ जाना. एवरी डे फॉर इयर्स टुगेदर विदाउट ब्रेक. नाउ दैट इज सच ए ग्रेट तपस्या हैज डन. यू थिंक द लॉर्ड विल नॉट ब्लेस और व्हाट? राइट? देन एंटायर 85 ऑफ भक्ति एंड भक्तना एंड भगवान विल बी कोलैप्स्ड ओनली आफ्टर व्हाट एवर ड्यू प्रारब्ध ऑफ दिस लाइफ इज ओवर. सच पीपल आर एलिवेटेड टू सच हाईएस्ट रैंक्स एंड पोजिशंस इन साधना. Like you have departmental exams. Sometime if you are highly educated also, from the lowest to the second or third level, who per se, to that also you can write exam and reach out. So such bhaktas. So darshana is clear. Mallinga mat bhakta jana darshana. Now today, did we have darshana of the Lord in our puja room? Properly, not mechanically. Spirituality is pouring yourself consciously, not mechanically. So too, in this week, did we visit a temple? When you visit a temple, go to a temple to have darshan of the Lord and puja. No other thing. Darshana. Second is what? Sparsha. Sparsha means what? Sparshana. Doing all types of sevas. Sparshana. If it is a guru, you can do the seva. To the mandira also, you can do the sparshana. Is the cleaning of all the abhishekas, whatever are done. Then archanam, next one. Archana is with all flowers doing the stotras and pujas, whatever are possible. So mallinga madbhakta jana ka darshana sparshana archana with the bhavana that you are doing to the Lord. What is required in the bhavana of the Lord with bhakti toward the Lord should grow in us. Our earlier life was of having darshana and sparshana and archana of the world. That habit has created such a strong vasanas in me that I am not able to become qualified to meditate on all pervading God, to be surrendered to God. To reach to that level, our indriya mano buddhi, which were attending to the world, which is mithya, are now diverted towards the Lord through these two means of madlinga and madbhakta jana. Let us be very clear about it. In all the upasanas, what is done is our dehendriya mano buddhyadi are pulled from the worldliness and offered to the Lord. This is a technique that is given. Once that habit of being worldly is gone, offering to the Lord has become natural, then you will be given the next stage of inquiry about nature of Lord, where you will discover Him as a Sat Gana Chit Gana Ananda Sarva Vyapaka Brahma Atma. But these are the things necessarily to be done. So darshana, sparsha, archana ho gaya. Then what else to be done? Paricharya. The paricharya is all required sevas. Called paricharya. So in the upasana, mallinga, madbhakta, mallinga, paricharya is whatever required to serve that Lord, do seva to the Lord in that temple. If you are a pujari, the paricharya is directly you do the upasana. If you are not a pujari, whatever the other paricharyas which we are allowed to do. In our own ghar mein, puja mandir mein, to paricharya is we are the one supposed to do, so let us enjoy it. All the time keeping in the mind that I am doing this to the Lord. So Lord should be in the mind, action should be happening around and about and towards the Lord, by which the laziness tamaguna also go away. The mind which was running so many places will be brought towards the Lord. Therefore, the next one is paricharya. Then says stuti. Stuti. So many thousands and thousands of stutis of all the devatas are given to us by so many great visionaries, masters. Some of the stotras they wrote before having darshan of the Lord. And with this stotra patana, it was so powerful that they had darshan of Lord. Many stotras they wrote after having darshan of the Lord also. But so all the stotras are powerful enough to bring that devotion in us, to please the Lord and to make the Lord give us his darshanam. That was stuti. If you are capable, you write stuti in your own bhasha, in your own way. You keep on doing. while doing it with shraddha, that stuti also gathers the strength, like the stuti of any mahatmas or writings. That's how their stuti also started and slowly gathered momentum and became powerful, and anybody used that stuti, they could invoke the Lord. If you can write, if you have the ability in your own language, nothing, nobody. Only Bhagavan Adi Shankar ke stotra padna is a guarantee nahi. He wrote and gave a chance to us, you can use them. He never said only follow this. You write your own. Your own stuti means not your personal stuti. Stuti written by you about your Ishtadeva. Make a support. After all these words and emotions are the means through which we tune ourselves to Bhagavan. The first stuti. So in that stuti, if you can write your own write, if you can't, you chant the mantras that are stotras that are already given in the Mahatmas. If both are not possible, at that moment in your own language, in your own mind, just to pray to the Lord. Do the stuti, the beauty of the Lord. And whatever the glories of the Lord you heard, and in your life, what are the best things the Bhagavan is giving to you, apne bhasha mein unke samne rakha hai na, this is called stuti. Stuti doesn't mean it should be in the poem form, and it should be in a very authentic, wonderful, cultured language of Sanskrit, etc. They are ultimate, there is no doubt. But in your own language, apne hindi mein, hey Bhagavan, aapka ye sundar mukhda, aapka ye jo bahut badhiya sa, ye vastra dharana, अलंकरण आपका देखकर मन बहुत आनंदित हो रहा है, मैं आपके चरण में नतमस्तक हूँ और आप मेरे जीवन में ये अच्छे चीजें जी दिए हैं, इन सब के लिए मैं आभारी कृतज्ञ हूँ, दिस इज ऑल्सो स्तुति. यू प्रेज द लॉर्ड इन दैट डूइंग प्रेज इज स्तुति. इसमें कोई ऐसे पोएट्री नहीं है, ऐसे महान व्याकरण नहीं है, नेवर माइंड दिस ऑल्सो इज अलॉट, बट फील दैट स्तुति भाव. Keep on doing that. Then next one, prahva. Prahva is that humble salutation. If possible, sashtanga namaskar, if you can do without the requirement of any fire engine, you do. Or else at least todasa. Best is the Punjabi style, Pai Lagu Swamiji or Mahatmaji. It is a dhamki type. Oh, that also you can do. But the feeling is important inside. And if one thing, if you ask me, what is that most helpful is, ability or regularity in doing the namaskara pranam to the Lord. Though the feeling is there in the mind, with the hands also you must do. With the words also you must express. The vacha and kaya and manasa also daily namaskara karo guru janon ka bhagwan ka janma dhanyo jayega. Every namaskara gets accounted. And how much time it will take? Hardly 5 seconds, 10 seconds. So prahva is salutation, namaskar. You can do sashtanga danda, whatever is said. There are mudra namaskaras are there about the Lord. So many are there, which we don't know. Thoda hum ek do shastra padhte utne jyada vistar nahi bata. But this much, prahva. Next one, guna karma anukirtana. Bhagavan's gunas and Bhagavan's karma and leela. Anu means always, kirtan means keep on singing. Sing you do yourself, not as a performer. In the initial days of Guna Kirtana of the Lord, they were sitting in the temple and just were singing by themselves. Seeing that people gathered and sat there, that is how that person became a Mahatma, and his singing became a performance later on. It was never started as the performance that I can sing the Kirtana of God. No. In the Bhakta's heart, naturally the Guna Karma Anukirtanam used to happen. And it is so enchanting to the audience, and they sat there. Then it became a regular. Every day used to come and do, every day they used to come and sit, okay? Like we are doing. Just talking on the Shastras, and you are coming and sitting. There is no effort that way. Struggle, etc. So, Gunanu Kirtana means, logon ko gather karke karo, ya apne aap mein karo, Gunanu Kirtana. Karma Gunanu Kirtana. If you do again this also with your knowledge, you do. Else all Puranas talk about the avatara and karma of Lord, and through that the guna of the Lord. So keep on doing Parayana. Parayana of these great itihasas, Puranas includes the guna karma anukirtana of Lord. That's what Vyasji did, and it became a Purana. That's what Valmiki did, it became a Ramayana itihasa. Is it clear? सो गुणानुकीर्तनम मत कर्म गुण मेरे कर्म के गुणों के भी अनुनित्यम कीर्तन करते रहना। इन दी साधनास विच में हाउ मेनी हैव टू बी डन, ऑल हैव टू बी डन, विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एवरी वन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट विच आई कैन डू इन दैट यू डिसाइड, बट डू समथिंग और द अदर। प्लानिंग इज यूर्स इन एंड थ्रू ऑल दैट वॉट शुड हैपन, द डिवोशन एंड सरेंडर टू द लॉर्ड इन अवर हार्ट शुड इंक्रीज, विदाउट दैट द थिंग विल बी ओनली मैकेनिकल, दैट वॉन्ट गिव द रिजल्ट। तो यू प्लान डेली 10-10 मिनट एक एक साधन आगे या हफ्ते वाइज और मंथली वाइज, और अमॉन्ग देम आफ्टर लिस्टिंग आउट अकॉर्डिंग टू योर एज एंड टाइम एंड टेम्परामेंट व्हिच आर द थिंग्स व्हिच कैन डू, डिसाइड देम एंड कीप डूइंग। ही इज गिविंग अ लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल साधनास बाय व्हिच वी गो नियर टू द लॉर्ड। व्हाट इज द नियरिंग ऑफ द लॉर्ड? ऑल अवर इंद्रियास, ऑल अवर अंतःकरण एंड वन ऑफ ऑल ऑफ देम कॉल्ड एज आई द जीवा इज मूविंग नियरर टू द लॉर्ड कॉल्ड एज उपासन। Next one, mat katha shravane shraddha. Again, the next one is having intense shraddha in the shravana of mat katha. Mere kathaon ka sunne mein bahut bharpoor shraddha. And Lord has taken so many avatars and so many leelas he has done. There were so many kathas are there for us. So shraddha, no, this won't happen overnight. For an egoistic person, he want to listen his own katha. One a desirous person, you want to listen katha of the jagat. Many people want to listen the kama katha or his own jiva katha. The very few people who are ready to listen shama and rama katha. So mat katha shravane shraddha. So means what? Shraddha, with shraddha, listening to mat katha will give you proximity to me, devotion and all. But it won't happen naturally. So you have to put an effort there. In creating Shraddha and with Shraddha listening. So I observe my mind now. Now I understand that in my mind there is no Shraddha at all to the Katha of the Lord. Why I never went? That means what? I must create Shraddha and with Shraddha I should do Shravana. So today let me try 10 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 15 minutes. Slowly Shraddha should increase, Shravana should increase. About the Katha of the Lord. And Bhagavan's two Kathas are one Nirguna Tattva Katha. Second is Saguna Avatara Leela Katha. Because through years listening only, it goes into the heart via Buddhi, of course. So by variety of Raga Dvesha Kama Krodhadi, we have filled our heart with the worldliness. Thus became a samsari, papi, duratma, durma, adharmatma and dukhi. So now by variety of things in our heart, we have to eliminate raga dveshadi and increase bhakti, prema, sharanagati, mahima gunanam of the Lord. We have to do. That's what it is. As simple as that to understand. Total transforming our personality's attendance from the world toward the Lord. For that all these help. And all these sadhanas have to be relentlessly done till that sharanagati bhakti happens. And after that, there's nothing more to pretend than this. Never this alone will happen. Such person by his own choice has liberated himself from his own ego and from his own worldliness. To just encourage, inspire us, whatever we are involved in, whether spiritual or worldly, that becomes a habit. Whatever becomes a habit starts giving happiness. But then this involving habitually in spirituality is the correct thing because it is about the truth reality. Involving in the world with all habit is not right because it's untruth, unrealities. Therefore, any day this sort of involvement will cheat us. But this will not, it will liberate us, it will bind us. That's how having the discriminating knowledge between both of them, only let us go on doing this. So mat katha shravane shraddha, fir mat anudhyanam uddhava. Taking more and more time to start doing the manana, chintana, dhyana as regularly, as long possible, as deeply as possible about the dhyana of both saguna and nirguna. Bhagavan ka rupa dhyana hoega, nama dhyana hoega, lila dhyana hoega, guna dhyana hoega, dhama dhyana hoega, swarupa dhyana. So mad anudhyana uddhava. Then only the distance we developed from the Lord and the proximity we developed with the world can be reversed. Madhanu dhyana muddhava. Now today's mind, if you observe how much worldly rajoguni that it is not able to focus on the Lord with dhyana. And it has happened, means not able to do dhyana, only for one reason, that we never tried. Tried sufficiently, tried regularly. So sufficiently, regularly you try it, ho jayega wo. See, in the same world of where we are living now, do you know there are thousands and thousands of people वो 4 बजे उठकर अपने गुरु भगवान का ध्यान कर रहे। शुरू में दे कुड नॉट अचीव, स्लोली दे आर नाउ ग्रेटली डूइंग, दे आर नॉट जस्ट रिवीलिंग आउटसाइड, दे आर देयर। यू गो टू द टेम्पल्स आर तीर्थ क्षेत्र, यू गो एंड सी, 4 बजे लोग खड़े हैं लाइन में दर्शन के लिए। एंड गो टू हंड्रेड्स एंड ऑफ आश्रम्स व्हिच आर देयर, सो मेनी साधुस डिफरेंट, दे आर डूइंग देयर ओन अर्ली मॉर्निंग ध्यान। But why we are saying this? They were also like us, but they started doing and continued doing that practice made it easy for them. So let us also. Mad anudhyanam uddhava, to mera dhyan karna. Anudhyanam, anu means all the time, lagata, jitna ho sake utna. Finish your vyavahara dharma, come for your dhyan. Like that. Then, sarva labha upaharanam dasena. So, all the labha, whatever we gain in this world, upaharanam dasena, just bring it and offer it to the Lord. When we are living in the world, so many things come to us, good things. Sab labh bhagwan ko hi chadhana. The salary came, the incentives came, the certificates came, the appreciations came, the rewards came, the awards came, the promotions came. Sarva labh upaharanam, just to the Lord only. जो भी मिल रहा है उनको ही ऑफर करना, तेरा तुझको अर्पण क्या लागे मेरा। एंड अल्टीमेटली इज वर्ड की आत्मनिवेदनम, नम दासेन आत्मनिवेदनम। सो सर्वलाभ उपहरणम इज व्हाट एवर यू गेट लब्धि ऑफर टू भगवान। सक्सेस हो गया बिजनेस में भगवान, सो यू आर सिलेक्टेड और इलेक्टेड एज कोई मिनिस्टर हो, ऑफर इट टू भगवान। सर्वलाभ उपहरणम भगवान, then dasena atmanivedanam is one, in this feeling of dasya bhava, just offer yourself also to me. Finally, like Hanuman ji, dasya bhava, greatest. Dasena atmanivedanam, what a beautiful thing. So just to see what are said, so many, mallinga madbhagjana darshana, then svarsha, then archana, paricharya, stuti, prakhva, guna karma anugir. This is for both of them. Now, toward the Lord, Mat Kata Asravane Shraddha, Mat Anudhyanam, Sarvalabha Upaharanam, Dasena Atmanivedanam. This is second set of sadhanas. So many very clearly told to us. Now, don't be confused. Main kya karo? Kuch to shuru karo. Whichever is feasible, possible to you, depending on the place where you are, situations, conditions around. Utna to dimag lagana hai na, main kaha hu, main kya, mere liye kya ho sakta hai? Utna to alochana karo. खुद का आलोचना कॉन्टेम्पलेट करो, डिसाइड करो। नेक्स्ट सेट इज व्हाट, वेरी ब्यूटीफुल साधना सर टोल्ड, मत जन्म कर्म कथनम। कथनम टॉकिंग अबाउट माय जन्म अवतारास एंड ऑल द लीलास। कथनम इज यू योर सेल्फ बी ए स्पीकर, सो फार यू आर लिसनिंग, नो नाउ यू स्टार्ट टॉकिंग। एवरी डे और एटलीस्ट ट्वाइस ए वीक और वंस ए वीक, make your children, grandchildren seated, and any of the stories of Bhagavan or Bhagavad Bhakta, you have to do the kathanam to them. You should tell them one day, no, I am telling you about this Shukadevji this day. Who is Shukadeva? The Vyasa Putra. By birth is a Brahma Jnani, but also great Bhakta. Then he has reached, approach Parikshitji when he was cursed. To that Parikshita, he gave this great Bhagavad Purana with 18,000 verses having all sadhanas to get a liberation. So 15 minutes ka unko Shukadev ka. Another day tell them, I am telling you about Valmiki. So tell the story how he became great Bhakta and Ramayana Adikavi. Adikavi. And Kavi Dhruva Bhagavan ka. Today I will tell you Dhruva Bhakta Dhruva. Sometime I will say about Prahlad ji. Sometime tell about beta is bar maha bhakta Arjun ke baare mein aapko batai. Sometime you tell ki I tell you about the Agastya Rishi. Valmiki Rishi, like that. In the same way, take about Avatara. I tell you about Ganapati now. I tell you about Subramanya Kartikeya Bhagavan. Is it not? I'll tell you who is Naranarayana, who is Mahavishnu, who is Bhola Shankar Shiva Bhagavan. I tell you about Mahalakshmi Devi, Saraswati Mata. So why not? And you can tell all the avatara, Matsya Kurma Varaha Narasimha, ऐसे बनाओ 10 हफ्ते, एक एक हफ्ते में एक अवतार का शॉर्ट एंड स्वीट बताना, 10 पतन मेरे को होना चाहिए बस, सो दैट द सीड्स एंटर इनटू देम. मोर देन दैट, व्हेन यू स्पीक यू बिकम रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू स्टडी एंड प्रिपेयर, दैट हेल्प्स यू मेनली. सो मत जन्म एंड इन दैट मत कर्म कथनम. इनफैक्ट कृष्ण अवतार का तो बताओ तो इट इज ए लाइफ लॉन्ग थिंग, यू कैन से टेकिंग द हेल्प ऑफ भागवत. But you can tell them, Bhagavan Krishna, this is okay on the request of the Bhumata and Brahmadeva and all Devatas. And then he was born there and he is here, and how he played his Leela of Prema in his childhood. And slowly Leela of Dharma when he was there, both in Mathura as well as Dwaraka. And during that, the Avatara Leela of Dushta Shikshana, Shishta Rakshana, Dharma Samrakshana, what is that? The more specification on his teachings to Arjuna's Gita, his teachings to Uddhava, this knowledge. मत जन्म कर्म कथनम हो गया. श्री राम भगवान को बताओ कितना बढ़िया है. टेल देम, लेट देम नो. इज इट नॉट यू टेल. सो मेनी आर देयर. ओके, देन कम्स मम पर्व अनुमोदनम. दिस इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट कि विथ ऑल द मोदनम आनंद मम पर्व, ऑल फेस्टिवल्स रिलेटेड टू मी हैव टू बी सेलिब्रेटेड. Never miss even one festival of the Lord. Every year, that's how the festivals come. So, Mama Parva Anumodanam is mainly Bhagavan Krishna's. That Janmatithi, Sri Krishna Janmashtami. Then, the Deepavali related to Lord Krishna, because he only killed the Narakasura, Bhaumasura that time. And every 11th day or Ekadashi is said to be the Bhagavan Vishnu related day. Every Budhavara or Shanivara also said to be Bhagavan Vishnu's name. So they're all Parva. So regular routine coming Parvas are the Ekadashis and Sunday, the weekdays. And yearly coming Parvas are all these special occasions of Narayana related, Vishnu related, any Shiva related. So you know, so Rama Navami ho gaya, Janmashtami ho gaya, ye sab kehte hai Parva Bhagavan ke. So Mama Parva Anumodhana means be conscious that the festivals are coming. Then a week before only prepare yourself and do. If that is not done, even during festivals also we become worldly only. The total jivan worldly hokar, aise hum bhayankar arthakam ke samskar bana lenge, ki bar bar only pashu pakshi inke hi sharir mein hamara janma hota rahega. On the other hand, in this way, as said so far and latest said called as mama parvanu modaram, in that when we involve, all our samskaras become divinized. Therefore, we are given less cumbersome and more convenient yonis in the further lives, which help us in sadhana. Remember, sadhya pata chale ja chal jaye. Sadhana kya hai pata bhi chale. Us sadhana karne ke liye. To do sadhana. The upakarana jo hai, the dehindriya mano buddhi, are most crucial and important. Because with that only we have to do the sadhana, which is intellectually understood. No, these are given to us depending on our vasana, samskara, earlier life. Up now, if we live a very noble life, we are given such a mana buddhi, which is so easily available to concentrate on the Lord. Ab dekho kaisa hai sadhava. Hota hi nahi Bhagavan ka dhyan karna. It is his gift. The Lord will give us the gift of such beautiful antahkarana if we pursue all these things. Now, we understand, isn't it? Baitne ko dhyan mein aadha ghanta hota hi nahi. Everywhere dharad. Imagine body is not in any pain. You know, stomach is not heavy. Indriyas are not tempted. They are strong enough. Mana is nishchala. How wonderful that equipment will be to accomplish the goal of spirituality. And if all these are there, 2 ghante ke 10 ghante aap baithoge, sunoge, main batate rahunga. And with the mind, you soak it in the story. Through the story into the glory of the Lord, through the glory of the Lord into the Lord Himself. Bete bete. Upakaranon ka shuddh karna bahut jaruri hai. All deha shuddhi, indriya shuddhi, antakarana shuddhi will happen through all these sadhanas. mainly mama parva anumodanam. The festivals of the Lord have to be celebrated. How exuberantly beautifully they have to be celebrated is the topic in the next 10 shlokas. Don't do it in a meager, minute way. Aisa ko diya wala jala diya ho gaya aisa. No. He is saying now how Bhagwan related festivals have to be celebrated. माता रानी रिलेटेड हो, भगवान कृष्ण रिलेटेड हो और राम रिलेटेड हो, शिव जी का कोई भी है. एंड नाउ यू सी वेदर दे स्टडी शास्त्रज आर नॉट, दोज आर डूइंग इन अ बिग वे, रियली दे आर डूइंग फॉर दोज सिवास, दैट्स हाउ दैट साधना गिवन इन दिस लाइफ, दे आर डूइंग सीरियसली. वी थिंक वेदांत इज ग्रेट, भक्ति इज ग्रेट, देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट दैट, इट इज ग्रेट, बट आर वी डूइंग? दे डोंट नो ऑल दिस, बट दे नो ओनली डू द विनायक चतुर्थी जन्माष्टमी इन बिग वे. And they do it big way, they get better results, outer and inner. देखो हम तो वो वेदांत नहीं करके वो नहीं करते हैं, और हमारे वेदांत का भी हम भरपूर नहीं करते हैं, और ना इधर ना उधर. If you really say that all these external puja etc. are little grosser, I'll do my subtler one, then do it intensely, do it seriously, do it regularly, do it deeply. You understand? On the name that I am a spiritual person, also we are cheated by our mind by not allowing us to do sadhana deeply, intensely, regularly, sincerely. When everything is convenient, once in a week, coming to class or sitting for japa or doing puja or going to mandir, ye koi bhi karega. Anybody will do that? It is the thing is on making it regular, sincere, in spite of all difficulties. That is one thing. Second one is, these Vama Parvanu Modanam. How it has to be done? Gita Tandava Vaditra Goshtivi Mat Gruha Utsavaha. Mat Gruha Utsavaha means the temples, when they are consecrated and all, the Utsavas are there. At the first time, the Mandira Nirmanam, Mandira Prana Pratishta, then every year Varshik Utsavas are there. 6 years also, the Kumbhabhishekas are there. 2 years or once, Mahakumbhabhishekas are there. They are called Gruhotsavas. Mat Gruha. The Gruha of the Lord is Mandira. Temple is the house of the Lord. In our own Puja Ram also temple, but it is not applicable to at home, but more applicable in the temples mainly. Mere Gruham ka Utsava, Bade Bharpur, Bade Paimane Pe Karna. In that what should be there? Gita. Make a lot of singings. Bring a good singers. And make a 1 week program. Then Tandava, bring all the great artists of dance who are the from Gandharva Lok only. ये लोग आते हैं नाचने वाले और गाने वाले. आप कोशिश करो नाचने का गाने का. नहीं होता हो, it's a great art, they're divine arts. Every art is divine, these are more divine. So they have come from Gandharva Lok. So bring them, ask them to do the Gitanam and also Tandava. तांडव तो एक्चुअली शिव जी का होता है, या तांडव इन नृत्य. तांडव इज वन ऑफ द नृत्य, सो मेनी नृत्य, दैट नृत्य व्हिच इज डन बाय शिव इज शिव तांडव. शिव नृत्य इज बट शिव तांडव, एंड इन शिव हिमसेल्फ नटराज रूप ही डज दिस डिफरेंट डांस. सो मेनी अवर ओन इन इंडिया हैज गॉट सो मेनी ब्यूटिफुल ट्रेडिशनल कल्चरल डांसेस. नाउ ट्रेन देम, दे आर ऑल सात्विक, दे आर ऑल गॉड ओरिएंटेड, दे आर ऑल भगवत लीला ओरिएंटेड. Is it not? Some modern youngsters also come up with their own uniqueness, but if it is not compromising with the divinity and all, chalega. In the lyrics as well as devotion, you know, in the leelas of Bhagwan. Is it not? You should not miss that fervor of bhakti. Usko aise light mat banana. And any time remember devotion and all, maximum little mediocre sound will be there. You cannot go out of control and dhoom dhadaka karo. Bahut kam jagah pe hota hai. That also when in the dance the pranaya work is happening, or in the dance they are demonstrating the Durga Devi finishing that Mahishasura etc. at that time. Otherwise it should be soothing, inspiring, devotional, encouraging in us in that sadagati etc. I'm talking about what sort of Gita and Tandava should be. Gita Tandava, singing and dance for the sake of Lord in the temples during the Grohotsavas of the yearly or whatever the programs. The third one, Vaditra, bring the instrumentalists also. Beautiful it is. Let them play. And all these three together they can do. Koi baja rahe, koi ga rahe, dance kar rahe. It's a beautiful thing. And these three things, audio, visual, and also this instrumentalization, instrumental, the audience will be fully pulled into. Because aankh bhi, man bhi, kaan bhi, sab us pe ho raha hai. So the dhyana will be more to that audience. Make it very beautiful. Very wonderful. And on the name of attracting public, don't dilute it as I said. If a group of that entire village are, or town are, Nan says rascal people not devoted at all, so they may not attend such, but you do it for the sake of Lord. Nahi aaye to chodab, kya kare? Like we do our shastra adhyayanam, patanam, if people don't come, I want, can I do? They don't deserve. But I keep doing. So Gita Tandava Vaditra ho gaya. Then Goshti Vihi. Goshti means satsanga goshti. The people who are well versed in shastras, they can explain to us the siddhi, sadhya means the goal to be reached, sadhana, the sadhana to be done, and the preparations for that. How to live our outer life so that we become introverted, how to have the inner attitudes, etc. So that we become more innermost through our bhakti and jnana towards the Lord. All these on the basis of shastra, there are some great mahatmas who are given that blessing of exponentials. They to speak about unka goshti banana. Un goshti mein agar mandir Rama ka hai, to let Ramayana katha go on. 7 years, every year one kanda. Ho gaya 7 saal, beautiful. Bhagwan mandir Krishna Janmashtami. To every year 2 skanda, 6 saal ke pura 12 skanda ho jayenge. Or saptahas you can have. There's so many people who are experts in that. We are not tapping them. Nowadays we are valuing the external artists of a entertainment type. The spiritual type people are being valued, going on, but it can be increased also. You can do your yogdan in that aspect. Mahatmaon ka satsang ho aise, aap sponsor karke, mahatma ke bhi aane jaane ka khane ka, and for the people, mahapunya. You know, that's how these Ramayana Parayanas, Lalita Vishnu Parayanas, then a Bhagavad Saptahas, the Yajamanas who make it happen, their Janma is Dhanya. All there is, wealth is very beautifully, rightly utilized. Because through those 7 days of Katha, in the entire atmosphere, again, the Bhagavan Sri Krishna's Kathas, Leelas are re-brought, renewed, renewal ho gaya. And that inspires the audience में से और कोई को भी चलो हम भी करेंगे ऐसे सप्ताह. So that goes on, that way we explain. Which is the way. Those days people were so many busy in so many activities, they never had time to think about entertainment. For them, every entertainment, every activity, every duty, every liberation sadhana were around Bhagavan and in the temple only. सब काम के लिए उनको मंदिर है. Even if some decision has to be made about the town or about the village, about two people's quarrel, mandir mein kehte ho. Shadi karna hai, mandir mein Bhagwan ke saamne. Yagnavid karna hai, wo bhi Bhagwan. Mandir ke charo taraf, Bhagwan ke charo taraf hota tha. That's how they were protected from being materialistic. But from last few hundreds of years, we are just forgetting the Lord and Mandira, then we have become so much extroverted. That has entered into the nas cell of the entire people, that so much of bhoga pravritti bahyatva has happened, that to remove all the dust and kachra, thousands and thousands of mahatmas have to work for the entire life, and yet it is not. That's a bhayankara thing which has happened last 2000 years in India, more so from last 600 to 800 years, where we are terribly attacked by the people. Right now, we are attacked by the materialism. The blindly, the science is going on discovering, and to every discovery, we are becoming slave and going more away from Bhagavan. A day should come, the science should stop now investigating, doing. देखो, सेलफोन डिस्कवर किया गुलाम बन गए, टीवी डिस्कवर किया गुलाम बन गए, एवरीथिंग कम्स एंड इज ओनली मेकिंग अस बाउंड। जस्ट ऑब्जर्व योर ओन माइंड एंड ऑल, वेयर इज द स्टेबिलिटी, वेयर इज द हार्ट मेल्टेड, वेयर इज द जॉय ऑफ सिंगिंग। नहीं हो रहा, वो 1 घंटा बैठते हैं तो 59 मिनट तो भगवान दुनिया के बारे में माइंड। इवन नाउ वाइल सिटिंग इन द क्लास, योर हाफ ऑफ द माइंड इज हियर एंड देयर ओनली, रिमेनिंग हाफ इज ऑन सेलफोन इन मैसेजेस एंड स्टेटस। दिस इज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द मॉडर्न डे। The entire universe of being should change. No, it all starts from the change of one being, and that being is you and me. How many Mahatmas in the subtle form are continuously, rigorously having meetings to bring again that earlier situation in the minds of all Jivas about the truth, about the reality, about the self, about service, about the Lord. Chala gaya, dekhte dekhte, kuch hi samay mein. How busy you keep your children in sending to schools, college, tuitions, time ही नहीं होता उसको मंदिर जाने के लिए, मत्था टेकने के लिए। Some places I go for yajna, 7 days I stay, one time that boy somewhere doing food he meets me. That much busy you keep the child that the Babaji in your house still you would know they can't meet the Babaji. Then how will he get the samskar? It's all बेवकूफी। तो मैं कही दूंगा आप कुछ भी मान लो कि सीइंग अदर्स वी गेट मिसगाइडेड एंड वी आल्सो पुट सेम थिंग्स इन आवर चाइल्ड। वी वांट आवर चिल्ड्रन टू बी सो ग्रेटली रिनाउंड एंड अचीव्ड इन द वर्ल्डली थिंग्स, वी डोंट वांट देम टू बिकम अ ग्रेट आध्यात्मिक व्यक्ति। वी आर मिसगाइडेड बाय, इफ दिस थिंग इज अंडरस्टूड यू विल नॉट सेंड यूर चिल्ड्रन टू सच स्कूल्स एंड कॉलेजेस where they are so stuck up busily that they can't do any of spirituality. Keep them in some mediocre place where they are not that much pressurized, they can do these also. Ultimately, उनके साथ यही जाएगा जो आध्यात्मिकता किया है, जो बाकी तुमने पढ़ा है, आपने उनको पढ़वा है, ये सब छोड़ के अगले जन्म में फिर से एलकेजी से पढ़ना पड़ेगा। That never goes with us. No, this you have to open in your heart to understand. Every talent in the world you have to teach them. No, it's a competitive world. He has to be like that, then only he can. ये सब हम बगा यार, 1.5 साल दिखा है ना हमको कोरोना देकर भगवान, घर में बैठो कोई टेंशन ही नहीं है। You are seeing from last 1.5 to 2 years, it's only imagination that we have to be great in the world outside. We have to be great in the world inside. So all these things that way can be understood. Now this is understood ki Gita Tandava Vaditra Goshti Bihi Madhura Utsavaha. This is the meaning. Ki do the Utsava of all the temples with all this fervor and in a big way as much as possible. Then what? Ki Yatra Bali Vidhanam Cha. Yatra means have pilgrimages. In an individually or family members or the group. What is the benefit in yatra is, first and foremost, we come out of the comfort zone of the house. That is the first tapasya. Second is, we go through all the hardships to reach the place of pilgrimage. That itself is second tapasya. There, one thing is what? One, like us, thousands are there. They were there also, there is a competition. But more than that, we understand that we are not the great devotee and we are not the only devotee. There are thousands are there. We can understand. The fourth benefit of yatra, tirtha yatra, is everybody's mind is tuned to the Lord. Therefore, it becomes easier to you. In the world, if you try to be spiritual, it's an odd man out. Everybody worldly. Suddenly, आओ भगवान का नाम लो तो हंसेंगे सर. But वास्तव भगवान का ही नाम ले रहे, तो easily you can do. And because the entire samashti is doing the anusthana upasana, the vibrations will be stronger. And once long time in that tirtha yatra, Bhagavan is being worshipped. Therefore, in that mandir or whatever, the presence of the Lord is very strong, easy to invoke him. So like this, so many benefits in Tirthayatra. And there you can do dana karma. There you can do the regular, more regularly or sincerely the anushtanam. Conveniences are there for that. Therefore, yatra. From a routine you come out, you'll be more inspired. And in this yatra, when you go, there's empty number of chances to come across some great Mahatma whose blessings will touch our heart, whose guidance will touch our heart, we may get fully transformed also. And doing Tirtha Yatra is what? Going out of, coming out of our own ego and going near to the Lord. That is sadhana. भगवान को हमारे यहाँ बुलाना साधना नहीं है, हमें भगवान के पास जाना है. दिस इज द टीचिंग द यात्रा टीचर्स. देखो यात्रा, देन द बलिविधानम. बलिविधानम मीन्स वेराइटी ऑफ द ऑफरिंग्स टू द लॉर्ड, वट एवर रिक्वायर्ड. ये बलि मीन्स अन्नदान इत्यादि. ब्यूटिफुल इट इज. इन इन द कंट्री एटली देर आर 50-60 और इवन मोर देन 100 टेम्पल्स व्हिच डू अन्नदान एवरी डे. Now each one of you, I am telling you, on the name of your parents or elders whose money you are enjoying, if at all, on their name, on their birthday or any day, there be annadana on their name in any of one of the temples chosen, you do it by the end of this month and tell me, if you afford it. So that permanently, unke naam par us din pe annadana hoega. I'll tell you, such a beautiful thing it is. Balividhanam. Go to Kashi, Annapurna Devi ko de do. Oh, thousands of people eat food there, Annapurna Krupa se there. Go to Tirupati Balaji, how many? Oh, Vaishnavi Dhama Langar waha lagate. These are all the genuine dhanam there. See, the bhaktas are fed there. When the bhakta is fed, the bhakti is fed. When the bhakti is fed, the Bhagavan is invoked. When Bhagavan comes, all negative goes away. This is called Bali Vidhanam. Giving the annadanam and all that. In that balidanam, so many things that are required for the temples and all that also can be done. So yatra, balividhanam. Balividhanam is not killing animals. Don't go into that thinking. Balividhanam. So then sarva varshika parvasu. That's what said. Sarva parvasu and varshika parvasu. In that annual parva is there of the temple. There yatra means that Bhagavan kai yatra karana. Is we go to Tirtha Yatra. Secondly, that Lord in the temple only, what we do the Yatra or Utsava around the temple and many times throughout the village also, town also, they do it. Then Sarva Varshika Parvasu, every year without break. I know some people throughout the year they are absent, but that 1-2 months of some Shiva Puja is there or Vishnu Puja is there, they are fully present. 11 months absent, but Margadi Masam they are available. 11 months absent, but Kartika Masa, Kartika Puja, they are there. 11 months absent, but Shravana Masa ko rehte ho log. Very good. At least that much. That's how it starts. And as they grow in their punya, ekatta hota hai, more and more time. So, yatra, balividhanancha, sarvavarshika parvasu, then vaidiki, tantriki, diksha. So, diksha hai lena. Vaidika diksha of what is vaidika diksha? In this three Vaidik Diksha, like Chaturmasa Diksha, 4 months, I'll completely study Bhagavad Gita with Bhashyam of Shankara. Or I'll study these 2 or 3 Upanishads thoroughly. Or I'll study the 4 first sutras of Brahma Sutra. This is called as Vaidiki Diksha. Vedka Diksha. Tantriki Diksha is all the Upasana Dikshas. Tantra is where there is less of knowledge, more of activity and devotion is there. Tantra is a process. Don't go into the meaning of the word tantra means koi tantrik hota hai. No. Anywhere where a systematic thing is done, that is called tantra. Entire upasana is called as tantra only. Through mantra and yantra. Like now in South India, the fever of, healthy fever of Swami Sharanamayappa, they start. From the November 15 up to January, it goes on. So tantriki diksha. Whatever they are thrown like that is 45 days, 42, whatever. They are so wonderful in their anushta. Ubayukna, thanda nahana, khud bana ke kana, jamin mein so jana. There are so many things they avoid. All the negative things. Never speak lies and all. Kya badhiya hai. And because of such people, such dikshas only, still some goodness is prevalent. Okay? There's no tantriki dikshas. Some take the Govinda mala, koi take माता रानी का माला कोई लेते हैं दीक्षाएं, है ना, सब लेते हैं शिव माला, दे टेक सो मेनी आर देयर, वंडरफुल इट इज कॉल्ड दीक्षा, वैदिकी दीक्षा, तांत्रिक दीक्षा. So many, I can't elaborate every one of them. Only hint is given to that. In the Vaidiki Diksha, you can also study the Veda mantras. I want to learn them in these many days. This. So, Shanti Mantra, some Suktas, then the Laghu Upanishads. Kupa Karo. What a beautiful, that's what we are doing from last 2 years. Almost 20 Shanti Mantras, we have Satsanga. We are not getting time to upload, people are not helping us much. We have done more than 15 of the Suktams. Exhaustive study we have done. The small Upanishads of Ganesha, Tarvashirsha Upanishad, Narayana Upanishad, Surya Upanishad, all that we have discussed. They will be uploaded. One year I have to take off from all classes. I think I myself have to do. That is Vaidika Diksha. This is also our Vaidika Diksha, where the Shastras we are regularly studying. Every day we are remembering Rama and Krishna and Tattva. Shiv Bhagavan bhi yaad aage kal se jab Shiv ji ka bhi shuru hua Tulsi Ramayan mein. Ho gaya Vaidiki Tantrika Diksha, then Madhiya Vrata Dharanam. That's what. All the Vratas which have come in tradition related to me, do those Vrata Dharanam. Madhiya Vrata Dharanam is writing the Rama Koti or Krishna Koti or Govinda Koti and going to that temple by foot and doing Pradakshina and on those days of that Lord doing the Upavasa, Dana, Kriya. These are called different Vratas. Madhiya Vrata Dharanam. Ekadashi Vratas. They're all there. Madhiya Vrata includes this. The one which comes December 15 to Jan 15. That Margali Vrata, every day morning Lord Krishna is invoked. Madhya Vrata Dharanam. These are the ones which we physically totally involve, then the mind. See, first bodily we have to go there. Then mind wise also we go. Like you come bodily to class, then slowly mind also gets tuned. If you don't go physically out of sight, out of mind. Itne sare bataye. Fair. One more sloka we'll see. Mama Archa Sthapane Shraddha is one of the very important things. That Mama Archa Sthapana means the establishment of temple. In that Shraddha, you must take initiative and show all the interest to establish the temple of Lord, which for at least few hundreds of years will serve thousands and thousands of jivas to become bhakta. All those are audience. Everyone must be contributor regularity to one or the other temple. The one which I said earlier, Anadhanam Alagoya. That is for your parents, elders. And this one is for your own sadhana and for the next generation. See, any temples we go, all those temples were built by somebody like us only in the past. No? So if we make it now, it will be useful for the future. Either you establish a temple where it is not there and essentially required, or already the temple which is there but not taken care, then help it. Pooja Gurudev has supported so many temples which were almost for lack of funds, nobody were maintaining. Jirana Mandir Uddhara Kaya Namaha, that is what is one of the names. So many Jirana Mandir ka Uddhara. Even to Badrinath, he is the one who gave first donation those years when it was very lowly developed. To so many mandiras, Gurudev used to give. Jirna Mandiro Dhara Kayanama. So either establish a temple, new one, or already a temple is there, renovate it, karo, or the temple which is going on nicely, something you can sponsor there. Okay, so I'll give the oil to the temple, or I'll give the naivedyam. Now these are all the ones which make the devotion slowly grow. So for all of that, first is Mat Archa Sthapane Shraddha. The Shraddha is the Sthapana of the Archa Murti called as Vigraha of the Bhagavan. Beautiful it is. You know that 3-4 years where we want to make a temple in which those 3-4 years we have spent throughout the day, our mind is soaked in only how to make temple. Now how much this makes the Lord happy, you can't imagine. क्योंकि एक अच्छा मंदिर बनाना है तो पहले जगह लेना है फिर पूरा प्लानिंग करना है देन यू हैव टू स्लोली कलेक्ट मनी फ्रॉम अदर्स यू आल्सो देन वन बाय वन थिंग ओनली स्टार्ट्स हैपनिंग इट अभी राम मंदिर अयोध्या में बन रहा है इट्स अ 4-5 इयर्स प्रोजेक्ट 2019 इट वाज डिस्कवर्ड इट इज डिक्लेयर्ड गिवन टू अस देन 2020 अगस्त 5th राम मंदिर इनॉग्रेशन हुआ शंकुस्थापना. सो 1 ईयर 3 months आर ओवर. नाउ टू मोर ईयर्स 2023 एंडिंग दे सेड. नाउ 2024 बाय मिड और टुवर्ड द एंड इट इज डन. बट ऑल दोज आर इन्वॉल्व इन दैट देयर माइंड आर सोक्ड इन राम ओनली. चाहे वो मूर्ति बनाने वाला हो, चाहे वॉल बनाने वाला हो या फ्लोरिंग कर, व्हेवर दे बी इलेक्ट्रिशियन हो, सब भगवान के लिए कर रहे. वो सब जन्म धन्य जीव है वो सब. मदर चा स्थापने श्रद्धा मीन्स मेक अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल एंड टू आर टूगेदर मेक अ टेम्पल आर यू योर सेल्फ कैन डू इट. बहुत बढ़िया. लॉट ऑफ डिटेल्स आई कैन स्पीक ऑन दैट विद लॉट ऑफ एग्जाम्पल बट इशारा काफी है. यू आर समझदार. Then swataha, that's what, samhatya cha udyamaha. Swataha, with your own resources you do it. Hota tha, bade jamindar agera, apne jameen ka ek jagah pe mandir banate the. Everybody used to attend it. But they are the ones, their family, which is the dharma karta pradhana. Pradhana dharma. And there is, you can see, my grandfather made that temple. My grand, itna anand hota hai sunkar. ఆలయ ప్రధాన ధర్మకర్త. స్టార్టింగ్ పీపుల్, నాట్ దీస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ నౌ పొలిటికలీ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ అండ్ గెట్ ద పవర్. ఐ సబ్ అబ క్యా బతాయ, ఐ కాంట్ స్పీక్ ఆన్ దట్ కంట్రోవర్సీస్. ఇట్ షుడ్ బి దేర్ ఇన్ దేర్ జెన్యూనిటీ. హూ ఎవర్ హూ పుట్ ఆల్ ది ఆర్ లిసనింగ్ దిస్ క్లాస్, లెట్ దెమ్ బి టోల్డ్ బై ద లార్డ్ ద ఇన్ యూ ఆర్ యూ గ్రేట్ఫుల్ ఫర్ ద పొజిషన్ గివన్, ఆర్ యూ జస్టిఫైయింగ్ ఇట్ ట్రూలీ సిన్సియర్లీ. Are you first of all becoming the devotee of the Lord? Are you only are becoming more famous than the Lord? Ye khud ko soch rahe hain. Usse hum to nahi bolenge. Why worry about them? We are talking about pradhana dharma karta. So swataha or samhatya cha udyama. Samhatya matlab gather people together, like minded. Is it not? Your own relatives can make a temple together. Your own friend circles can make a friend temple together. Is it not? In your own factories, you must have a temple. No, no, in my factories, other religious people come. Remove them if to remember the Lord if there is an objection. That Lord, because of whose grace you have the factory, you don't want to put that Lord's photo or vigraha there and for the sake of afraid of 2-3 useless fellows. Every one of you who have an office or any company, and if you are true Hindu, you must have a temple there. Let a pujari come and do puja every day. You only do Deepa Aradhana once in a week. Little your family should go and do it. What is this? How can anybody object? Ours is eternal dharma, sanatana, in which all these have come. Now latest few people came and usko dar karam nahi karte. Every government office should have a temple. And people should do namaskar to them. ये नो जे राज्यांग कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ही भगवान है, प्रजा ही हमारे मंदिर है, ये सब नाटक है. भगवान इज भगवान, nobody can take place of him. And we are in our Indian Hindu country, our own Hindu temple, God only should be there. That's it, folks. There's no controversy. Just pass the rule, that's it. Don't give a chance even to discuss. That's it. That's what they do in all the Western countries. That is how so many churches, they don't, the government never dares to question them. They do it. They permit it. But jo bhi hai, individual or in groups make temples. Then around the temple, Udyana, Upavana, you know, for the flowers, for the leaves, for the Lord, organize them. Then Akrida. Akrida means the variety of Bhagavan related things to do. Then Pura Mandira Karmani. Pura Mandira Karmani, in that Pura, making Mandira, in that whatever the karmas to be done, be a part. These are all the divine activities. Now, few more slokas are there. With this, we'll do the conclusion, I think, tomorrow. Sarvam Krishna Arpanam Om Purnamadam Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Krishna Chandra Bhagavan Ki Jai. Sadgurunath Maharaj. Jai. Thank you. In 2 minutes, come back for Ramayana. Hari Om, friends.